coming to you from Radio Democracy 98.1 FM. If you remember, inside 2015, the president, Dr. Onyedzbai Koroma, besieged the first and vice president, Alhaji Sam Sumana, and replaced him with Ambassador Victor Bokarifo. This decision will be going on well with Sam Sumana and be going at the Supreme Court in Salon. Usai, the Migefo will say the president get right for pull him in office because he lost his membership in political party will be there. Well, Alhaji Sam Sumana be taking this matter going at the ECOWAS court, who said this case don't carry on for some time now, and government not be good representation at this case. And finally, yesterday, the ECOWAS court in Abuja don't give ruling. Well, on the line now from Abuja, we get journalist Ibrahim Samura. We be there live now the court session and go tell we what really happened there yesterday. Good morning, Ibrahim, and welcome to the program. Hello, Ibrahim.
Hi, good morning, and Tidpentuan.
Yes. That's what tell me about how the atmosphere be look like now the court yesterday where the judge them now the ECOWAS court be the gide ruling.
Of course it was jubilation on the part of families of the former vice president Alhaji Samuel Sam Sumana. But then what was interesting there now the fact that many people, including lawyers, we witnessed the trial. See, it looks like a landmark thing because the ECOWAS court ever in the history of its existence, not ever done. Always they deal with small cases like we individuals. They take government to court, to the court for either payment or not payment on issues of transactions. But that this one now, it was the first of the biggest of a case where the court don't hold, and then it was dealing with a former vice president who was seeking legal redress on an issue of a removal by in government. So that was really a landmark thing to a number of lawyers. We particularly I talked to, and then how they viewed it. But then we should also look at what's in this case where Sam Sumana have been bringing before the ECOWAS court. And then the court in the verdict, they say Sam Sumana have been asked for a right to fair hearing. They been also asked for a right to participate in politics within Northern Gaya. He also been asked for a right to due process of the law. He, over and above all, asked that the court look into a removal from office where he see was unlawful, and then also ask for damages and costs.
So what did the court end up saying? Because we know what the one that we popular now the one on the cost in salary and other benefits, mm-hmm. Then what they say the government for GAM and SERF, where they say...
Okay, that's the cost, it's popular. But then also, waiting much more interested in this context, now the unlawful removal where the court say the Salon government and President Koroma not been utterly get any right for remove the vice president from office. Now on the issue of damages, the court say the government of Sierra Leone, because they remove this man as vice president wrongly, therefore pay everything will be endured from the time we then pull out from office to the time where in time be done constitutionally. And what in the account for, they make a total calculation of monetary value on things including in salary, allowances, and prerequisite. In fact, in the prerequisite, then they look at then think the way vice president for benefit when you go at the office. That is, if you do forget car, from that time day to now, then they put her into monetary value and pay that cost. If you forget telephone benefit, top up cards, and health benefit, holidays or vacation, all them things and then put them together and say therefore give them to the former vice president.
They're able to put out like to almost money that they will cost. The court will talk about almost money that they will cost.
Well, I think after the verdict is read, the lawyer of Sam Sumana Atuguba, Raymon Atuguba, a Ghanaian, of course, because the lead counsel winner, Femi Felana, virtually not been in court for an unavoidable reason. Been therefore come up with that, say, and the court talk but cost, but not tell waiting that written God. So the president of the court winner, a French Malian, being therefore say that would be handled with an office of the registry, and then once that is done, it will be communicated to the lawyers for their understanding.
Right, Ibrahim, let me look at the aspects of reinstating Sam Sumana, which was some. Plenty of people so far reaction they would only get in a salon, even on social media. Now how then it was possible for Kari and State Sam Sumana again as vice president in a salon?
Well, the court not directly say therefore reinstate Sam Sumana. In fact, it make a clear say it will not decide for touch on that for two reasons. One, the lapse as predicated by the laws of Sierra Leone and the constitution, and then he also look at the issue of security. He said because they're not going to want to create a situation where chaos within the country. But then they emphasize on the fact that Sam Sumana was wrongly removed, and then go to a point for even define jurisdiction when the argument with the government of Sierra Leone put forward vis-a-vis the matter before the ECOWAS court.
So, what do you say specifically?
Article.
Yes, what do you say in A of 1 that government said they make representation because they feel say the court's not going to do jurisdiction over Salon, and 2, the Supreme Court's ruling will be happen on the same case?
First of all, they make a clear say, in fact, the exact word they use, they say, the argument put forward by the Sierra Leone government on the area of jurisdiction completely unintelligible. We need to say, it don't make any sense. And what even do they tell for even say, Article 9.4 and Article 10b on the protocols for the establishment of the court make clear of reasons of jurisdiction on member states, and it says Sierra Leone has signatory to that. So if Sierra Leone denouncing another jurisdiction, that is completely out of context and it don't make any sense.
All right, well, one for taking plenty. Thank you very joining the line. Ibrahim Samurai, journalist from Sierra Leone. We witnessed this ruling in Abuja yesterday, and we will follow up on for no witness the latest way they happened there today.
And we still there on the issue of the first and vice president, Sam Sumana, we ECOWAS yesterday give ruling. Well, Radio Democracy Michael Sambola meets with the Attorney General Minister of Justice, Joseph Isjia Kamara. We give respond.
We don't see the release it, but we don't they observe on different media outlets say the ECOWAS court don't give a decision on the application of the former vice president. Yes, we don't aware about it, and we don't take a position as a government.
So you say I don't take a position, what's in this position?
The position are the same way we've been get before for say ECOWAS not get jurisdiction, meaning they not get right to handle a case where we young courts they done with the Supreme Court win at the highest court in the land based on which in the constitution say for let them say go area. The ECOWAS court for we opinion at the law office not to court of appeal for Salon.
And at the basis standing we make on an economic representation at government?
Yes, certainly Sambola. When we tell them say they don't get jurisdiction, that they don't get right to hear that case, we don't go there. We say no to them business. We don't do with the case in this country. We highest courts in the land don't take a decision. We not so the constitution say. And we accept them, we live by that. And that is the end of it.
I remember inside an interview where they talk about you go defend waiting the president to do no matter what happened, you go stand by in land and sea. So waiting go wrong with that point today.
Nothing will go wrong with that point there. If you mean being any legitimate court, we get right for hearing the case, we go did it. But this not court, we don't get right for hearing the case. And in any country, we didn't call the basic law, not the constitution. We're not the highest law in the country, and we work by that. due process may apply in that case. It go to the High Court, it go to the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court sit down, then listen, then give judgment. We all accept it in the judgment. Not to alter, you get forget judgment in your favor, you gladly. But when you go to the ECOWAS Court, the ECOWAS Court then get the new mandate. They don't get mandate for review judgments of the Supreme Court. Winner is sovereign state of Sierra Leone. Meaning say no other body no day will they dictate what we country law don't talk.
Right. If you look, Sierra Leone government don't adhere to ruling of the ECOWAS Court. Not to the ECOWAS Court to give ruling where Sierra Leone government they adhere to. That businessman on that wobble stuff. Government don't adhere, they don't pay that kind of compensation to a whole businessman where ECOWAS Court been give judgment to. So why the difference?
Well, at the good point now and day, who side then get jurisdiction? We apply. We comply with what they say. That means say we respect them all. Who side then correct? Who side we know say they not get right? If they pass any judgment, we know they accept them and we know they recognize them.
So sign of the right way they not get because the judgment they talk about, the president, Kuma government, Saka illegal one, they for pay them all the money since 2015, and most importantly, they say for reinstate and back in imposition. So Usai, they not get right.
Usai, they not get right now for even hearing the case in the first place. When we own Supreme Court don't decide, they don't confirm the legality of the process. They not get right for come back and review with Constitution. They not get right for come review with Supreme Court. Now that are the toxic, they not get right at all. We get a recent case of Tayyip Bah. Despite the outcome, we still get a negotiated settlement. So we come to in a country law-abiding, where they follow the law, even international law, where it is correct. In this particular instance, this specific case of Sam Sumana, we say no, we no get right. So when they insist they get right, we say okay, we try it. We do na yombo kutok. We no mix panat court.
So they don't make them judgment now. Waiting government to think about the judgment.
We get simple statement to they make regarding that. Not to be business, we know the inside day, we not participate, we not recognize the judgment, and we know the support up, and we know they comply by that.
So the government so they pay the money, you mean, to the former vice president, and also government they think of against the term back and in position?
It is interesting we come to issues of dismissal. In issues of dismissal in public law and employment law, we don't dismiss policy in order to claim of right to in benefits and other issues. That is the situation. But in the same case, in the same vein, His Excellency the President get a prerogative if he feel like. There are procedures for that. If former Vice President Alhaji Sam Sumana want make claims for any benefit, you know what he for do. Yes. And if the President feel for exercise the prerogative, for sorry for her, he can sorry for her. But as a matter of law, where there is a dismissal, you need to come back and ask for benefit.
You think that this is a matter of sorry for him rather than what he entitled to?
Well, the entitlement is a question of law, and the courts then in this country don't decide that.
Many people who I talk to, see, because they you know, get a clear judgment with them, they expect, see, they don't question even the Sierra Leone judiciary.
Well, it's a point of view you go say question, everybody free for talk with you and talk. You go say they talk cheap. But within the law is very clear. You get to accept a judgment. You know, may say because the judgment no favor you, so therefore the judgment wrong. In this particular instance, we don't even look at the merits of the judgment. When the talk say they know for Yeri that case, they don't get right. We come to the issue of his claim or fundamental breaches of his rights and other issues. That was also dealt with in our courts. And we get law the way they apply, and there are beneficial things. And at the same time, we always say there has to be an end to litigation. If case begins, side away for tap away for finish. The ECOWAS court inside mandate, nowhere not in the ECOWAS protocol. We talk say in a court of appellate jurisdiction, meaning say, na court we can appeal go to from you Supreme Court. No part not the way it talks so. And at that issue, we address to the registrar.
In as much as we don't make a case, then go ahead for hear the case and self grant or then pass judgment. And you not think say if we not comply, then they go question the relationship with Sierra Leone get with ECOWAS.
Well, of course, there has always been a few recent dealings with the ECOWAS court. As a lawyer myself, I did inquiry with many of the judgments of the ECOWAS court. I did inquiry with the interpretation of the mandate. But definitely, the personal query or the office query may they interfere with which we believe in the legal rights of persons. And so therefore, the decision we don't take, we shall not participate. That's not their decision. In terms of enforcement, we will not be a party to it, and we continue to get any exposure of liability under those circumstances. we don't get any enforcement of judgment consequence. Like I get in other countries, in other international treaties, what we call enforcement of international judgments. We don't get that type of relationship. And most certainly also, we are members of ECOWAS. And this now, you're quite correct, it trigger a questioning relationship with the different heads of government in relationship with ECOWAS. Because no government of the 16 member states will accept a decision such as this. Because if we not be careful, the ECOWAS court go wake one it and change any government.
People go arguing at this time they talk about for the first time the procedure for sack elected vice president. Now did the question be there and now did the whole thing begin?
Yes, that was the question, but the courts have decided.
So when they not make this then judgment and then come saying that the ruling this to the government for a day or two, what thing will be the step?
Well, again, no step there, then I their own business. What in they decide, that then business.
The former vice president, tell I listen to I say, even if I want ourselves, for let come back and serve, for sure say, the process where the president use for Pulham, illegal and unconstitutional, he will dearly serve. With that kind of mandate, now we get a kind of spirit and they coming back now the country. When government not ready for changes, stance. Do you not think, say, now room for conflict?
I found that statement very interesting while listening to the discussion. Because how you they come back? One day nobody no dribble. Now you go for himself. If he say they come back, then country can come. A citizen is welcome. But how you they come, now you go advise yourself. Within the legal thing we get for do. Inside salon, the law don't decide. We have now a sitting vice president who is occupying the office. If you come, you claim say you're not vice president or any other position you own. And so therefore, you dey come for car enforcer in any other means. I want to say I go do that one day. The vice president office was Abusa Ide. We come, let waka go there, go take in place if I get there.
And we continue for look inside this issue as we talk to more people. Musa Iwan, private lawyer Solomon Jamil, will say the outcome of the ECOWAS court between former vice president Chief Alhaji Samsumana and the government of Salon for be serious concern to Salon government and people. As he says, Salon has signatory to the ECOWAS court of justice. Solomon Jamil inside this interview is Mohammed Sherif. Explain more.
Court finally don't give verdict relating to the complaints where former Vice President Alhaji Samsumana became on the ECOWAS court. I'm not privy to the text of the judgment yet, and Mr. Fuiliwan for read them and see what in at the jurisprudence, look at the ratio, the obiter, but I think if that is the situation, it's going to impact considerably on the jurisprudence and also on the justice system.
What do you mean it get for impact on the justice system?
We all know say the Supreme Court with a panel of five justices, we don't hand down a decision, and that decision they not be they in favor of Alhaji Samsumana will be warrant a recourse to the ECOWAS court. For me, it's like an imbroglio now, because the Supreme Court, which is the highest court of the land, had given a decision saying that what the president did was constitutional. So if the ECOWAS Court of Justice now don't come with a decision and it is suggesting that what was done to Samsumana was not proper, then it means now we have two contradictory situations.
The ECOWAS court just don't pass a verdict between the former vice president and the Salon government. Two things will clearly come out. The court actually asks the government of Salon for actually reinstate the former vice president and same way so pay all in benefits them back. As a lawyer, you think say as much as the country gets another vice president of the country, this in any way possible?
For me, it is the issue which has to do with whether constitutional guarantees have been vindicated. The other aspect we want to make me comment on, let's say the court is asking for Samsumana to be reinstated, and let's say the court is also asking for damages to be given to Samsumana. The court no one for make an order in vain. And this, as we say, it's an international jurisprudence that is growing.
Yeah, we are saying government actually not been sent any representative now the ECOWAS court for represent the state on this matter. This in any way gets any effect, both positive or negative, on the state?
Well, first of all, now government be elect the option not for submit to the jurisdiction of ECOWAS. And because they take the decision not for submit to the jurisdiction of the ECOWAS, if they send any representative, it will constitute a waiver of the objection. Once you don't object to the jurisdiction of a court, then you not for submit to them. But I think that would have some far-reaching implications, because this brings me to a very important issue, and this is very important. The question as to whether the decisions of the ECOWAS Court of Justice binding or no member states. Me think say member states they not meet and sign up to protocols and sign up to treaties in vain. They are bringing the analogy of what we call a valid contract. You get three elements where they constitute a valid contract. You get the element of agreement, inside the parties the way they contract, therefore be very clear as to the subject matter of the contract. You have consideration and then you get intention for be legally bound. And this is not the general rule. The presumption is that when parties then they go into a contractual dealing, it is presumed that they intend to be legally bound.
So Sierra Leone legally bounded?
Well, this is the question, because the issue is, if you as a member state go sign up to an ECOWAS treaty and you as a member state go sign up to a protocol where they set up the ECOWAS Court of Justice, then by necessary implication, you are saying, I am prepared to honor the decisions of the organization to which I am a signatory. That is the issue.
According to government, say the outcome of the verdict of the ECOWAS court, they know they accept that. As a lawyer, you think say this in any way will affect the country or the state?
Once you sign up, you are a signatory to a treaty, you are a signatory to the protocol. By necessary implication, there are contractual obligations. And I think for me, really, it's an imbroglio.
What does that mean?
It's an unfortunate and absurd situation. I think it doesn't set a good precedent. Now, the reason why I want to make we take this seriously as Sierra Leoneans is this. When they set up the ECOWAS protocol, when the protocol was enforced in 1993, we set up the ECOWAS Court of Justice. When they say in 2005, the ECOWAS Court of Justice now has jurisdiction not only to hear, but also to determine cases relating to violation of human rights. As a matter of fact, then we give that court the jurisdiction for interpret and enforce the African Charter on Peoples and Human Rights. And that is a very fundamental charter where they deal with human rights for member states. And Sierra Leone is a signatory. So if the ECOWAS Court of Justice will now come with a decision that speaks volume about our human rights situation, me think say as a Sierra Leonean, it's a cause for concern. And so if somebody want to ask the question, how serious is this decision? Whether as a government we should think very seriously about it, I am not forcing anything through the throats of government. But me think say, when you sign up to a treaty, you sign up to a contract, the presumption in law is that you intend to be legally bound.